Hello friends, today I'm going to show you how to prepare yard long beans by cutting them with bare hands. So this is how my aunt prepares yard long bean at her home. So she has paddy fields, and after the harvest of the paddy, they will cultivate a lot of yard long beans. And yard long bean is a leguminous plant. So if you go after the harvest, and so when there is a lot of this yard long bean at home, my aunt, she prepares the leguminous vegetable by cutting with her bare hands. So she says that if you don't use any metal, the knife, which is a metal, the taste will be much better than preparing you by cutting with a knife. And so today, you know, I'm going to the stone age, before the metal age also. So I'll be using my hand to cut the yard long beans. So yard long beans, you see the right kind of yard long bean for cooking is the one which is firm. So when you cut it, it cuts very fast. It's firm, and so if the skin is soft and the seeds are little ripened, then that won't be good for frying. So in that case, what we do is we will remove the skin and take out the ripe seeds, and then add them to the add it to the and use that also for cooking. So at home, in when my aunt prepares, we all like to have more of the seeds in it. The more seeds in it, it's nuttier and tastier. So and crunchier also. So we love to have this crunchy seeds in the yard long bean. The taste of this stir fry is very nutty, chewy and firm, and it's a very good combination with the rotis and with rice also. Yard long bean is known by different names. It is known as the asparagus bean, the long podded cow bean, the Chinese long bean, the snake bean, pea bean, and a variety of other names. And it's some people like to have it fresh, raw also, and that is also good if you can eat it that way. So today I'm going to go into the stone ages, and I'm going to use only my hand to cut the vegetable. So my aunt says that when you use the metal, the taste will be lost. So today I'm not going to use that also. So see how it is. So see, it's such a tedious process that I'm changing the position from one place to the other again and again. And you know, this is actually, you should do this whole cooking when the whole family is there, when there are little kids around. They also love to come and sit and cut the vegetables with bare hands. That's what we do when we go to vacation to my aunt's house. So since I am going to the stone age today, I am not using the metals. So I am using a stone pestle, and crush the onion, the garlic, and the chilies. Okay, for a difference today, and the taste is much different. And the advantage today in this age of pandemic is that since you are not using the board or the knife, you can be assured that you are avoiding that much of bacteria that could have come from the board and from the knife. So I'm completely using my hands, bare hands, for cooking, for a difference. And I'm sure it will taste much better, different. It will taste different because we have avoided metal while cooking. And I'll mix the ingredients, the turmeric, the chili powder, the salt, everything with a hand itself. I'll nicely mix it and then fry. So please, you do try this recipe today, and do give your opinion about how you felt having prepared the green the beans without using a knife and by using your bare hands. So share your experience definitely. Before I sign off, I'd like to remind you one thing. According to the YouTube analysis, 98% of those who watch the cooking daily videos have not subscribed to the channel. So only 2% have subscribed. So dear friends, please do subscribe to the channel. For us, it will be an encouragement for us to put more interesting videos, to do more research, and to come up with more interesting and useful recipes. So please do subscribe to this channel and keep watching and sharing these recipes. Thank you.